Are you struggling with being productive and getting stuff done? Are you overwhelmed with all of the different things that are on your plate and the different things that you coulda, woulda, shoulda, oughta, mighta be doing? Do you have trouble picking one thing and sticking with it over time? You probably do. If you are a creative freelancer or solopreneur, you are not alone. Hello, I am Aura McKay. I'm the founder of Business of Creativity, and welcome to Coaching for Creatives. And today we are going to talk about how constraints, structure, and limitations can support you in feeling less overwhelmed, being more productive, and ultimately consistently attracting clients and work that you love. And you may be thinking, okay, Aura, listen, I get it. I know that in business we're supposed to have some structure, but I'm creative and I just want to have freedom and I want room to express myself creatively. And gang, I totally get it. But let me share a little story with you from when I was setting out in the early 90s to travel the world, to live my dream. I had been working really, really hard to save a bunch of money, and I had been dreaming of being an international traveler with my backpack and having an incredible adventure. And so off I went, and when I went, I only bought my ticket for the first few months of the trip. So the first sort of like 7 months of the trip, I kind of sort of knew where I was going. Well, I knew I was going to go to the Fiji, Cook Islands, then New Zealand, and then Australia. I didn't really know how long I was going to stay, but I had visas. And so the visas created a limitation about how long I could stay in each of those countries before I had to leave. So for instance, in New Zealand, I only had a 2 month visa. So I had to leave after 2 months. And I got to Australia and I had a 6 month visa. So already there was a constraint about when I had to leave that country. And I could have left sooner, absolutely. But I knew I had all the way up till the boundary, the limit was 6 months. And by knowing that I had a limit, that there was a finite amount of time that I was going to be able to spend in the country traveling and enjoying it, that limitation really helped to bring me present to enjoying every moment of that trip, to being really mindful about what it was that I was actually doing in that moment, because I knew it wasn't going to last forever. But then right after I left for, I left Australia, and I should back up. There I am in Australia. I know my visa is running out, but I don't have a plane ticket and I don't have a destination for my next spot. I have opportunity ahead of me. I could literally go anywhere in the world. I mean, at that time, we're talking about 1994. I had sufficient funds. I had a visa. I had no restraints against where I could go. Maybe, you know, speaking the language, but I could probably find a field guide for that. So there was really wide open opportunity. Anything was possible. And gang, that level of wide open opportunity completely stopped me in my tracks. I had what I now call opportunity paralysis. I had no way of being guided to or gently nudged in the direction of, okay, yeah, but this is the only thing that's possible for you. Anything was possible, and it stopped me in my tracks because I didn't have a framework. I didn't have to go, yeah, anything is possible within this dollar amount. Anything is possible within these number of days. Anything is possible within these constraints, these limitations to it. And it was really shocking to me to have all of that possibility laid in front of me, to truly be able to choose whatever I wanted. And you would think, oh my gosh, I've always wanted to be there. What a privilege. And truly, truly, what a privilege. Truly, what a privilege. And we think that it would be this amazing experience. And what ended up happening is that it was really challenging for me. I couldn't figure it out. I kept looking at all these things. I got information overload. Because there was no constraints, anything was possible. I just started to get more and more and more and more information, because at some point there's gonna be a limitation and then I will be able to make a decision. And the thing that finally forced a decision was that my visa was expiring. And so then I had to choose where to next. And what I learned was that if I can create a framework or some limitations or some constraints over what it is that I want to do, it's way easier for me to make a decision. And most of what we are doing as entrepreneurs is making a series of decisions all the time. I know you're exhausted from wearing all of the hats in your business. Part of that is because you're making all the decisions all the time, and there are so many of them to make. So one of the things that having a constraint or a limitation or a structure can bring to you is that ease of having to make really big decisions all the time. It limits what you have to consider as a possible option, so you're not stuck in that sort of perpetual, well, what about this? Well, what about this? Well, what about this? Well, what about this? So many of my clients, so right now I'm running one of my signature programs, the Marketing Confidence for Creatives program. And so many of my participants came into that program going, well, I have all of these different tactics. I have all of these different things. And I've heard this from this person. And I've heard that from this person. And I've heard this from that person. And there's so many ways and opportunities and possibilities for how you could market yourself. Where do you even start? And that where do you even start is the value of having a structure or some kind of a constraint, so that you're not having to consider all of the options in the entire world. So for instance, in marketing, some of the constraints that you could consider is, well, who am I actually talking to with this message? Because not all audiences are going to be in all places under all methods. So just even the constraint of focusing on one audience for your marketing message, or the limitation of saying, you know what? All I'm gonna think about is this one marketing channel, one thing at a time, or focusing and creating those limitations. Today, I am practicing one of the things that has supported me in being consistent, in attracting clients and work that I love, in keeping my word to myself, and setting up a habit around marketing. And that has been picking a specific day and a specific time to do these Coaching for Creatives live broadcasts every single week. That constraint of, I don't have to worry about what day I'm gonna do a live broadcast this week, and I don't really feel like it on Tuesday, so maybe I'll do it on Wednesday, and then something happens on Wednesday and I can't get on the internet, and so on and so forth. So there's none of that. It's, I am gonna be doing it on Tuesday. I'm unstoppable about Tuesday. I don't have to worry about trying to have to figure it in. I don't have to keep it top of mind and wonder how I'm gonna schedule it. It eases all of that bandwidth from my brain. It eases all of that having to carry it around and think about that decision around making that choice. So Tuesday, super clear. And I don't have to think about what time. Tuesday at 2:00. Every single week. So even when I get up in the morning and I don't feel like it, guess what? I'm still gonna do it. And that's another value of having a structure or a limitation in place, is that it removes the aspect of what do you feel like, or it can anyways, and gets you back connected to what is the action that's going to make a difference for you. So having structure in place, having a constraint of, yes, I'm gonna do live broadcasts, but I have no idea what I'm gonna talk about, and I don't know when I'm gonna do that, and do I do it on my page, and do I do it in my group, and how do I, all of those decisions to make are exhausting. And so if you make the decision once and create that as the constraint or the structure or the limitation, now you don't have to be making all of those decisions and exhausting yourself. You can focus on the content. You can focus on the connection. You can focus on the meaning and the execution. And I also created a part of the structure to give me flexibility. I created it so that it is a live broadcast. So it is on my cell phone and can be done from anywhere. And there's really no excuse. I haven't set up the constraints and the structure so that they are unsupportive. I've set up constraints and structure that support me. Another thing that people complain about a lot is that they're just not able to take consistent action. Well, having a structure for consistent action. So having a system where you have a support partner, that's a structure. Having a calendar or a productivity tool, that can create a structure for your day. A few months ago, when we first started experiencing some of the shelter in place and the furloughing that was happening with a lot of people, the regular structure of people's days or the structure of their week completely went out the window. And that lack of structure, that lack of sort of a framework or the parameters to kind of navigate your way through, created a lot of dis-ease and uncertainty and confusion and fog and disconnection from their business. And what I've noticed is the clients that I'm working with who are bringing structure back into their day, who are scheduling things, even if it's scheduling like go watch that webinar or go for a walk outside or, you know, make your post on social media today. It doesn't have to be meet a client or do a sales meeting or do post-production on a project. You can create your own structure for your day. And the clients that I have that have been structuring their day and structuring their time and creating that space have expressed way more creativity, motivation. They are connecting more to their ideas and innovation because they're not tapping out all of their energy on making the decisions about when and what to do things. They're just going in and saying, okay, I know I'm gonna work on this for 2 hours, and then they can be creative and spontaneous and flexible within that framework. Gang, constraints, limitations, structure are critical to being able to give us space for our creative expression to be able to run wild. It is such a key part of my success and the success of my clients that I really encourage you to reach out, to make a comment. If you're struggling with this in your life, like how do I create structure? How do I leverage restraints? So creating structure, there's lots of different ways to do it. And I've talked about a little bit about how to leverage them. So if you have questions, pop it in the comment box. I'm going to share one little extra story for you and an invitation to go check this out on YouTube. The first time I was introduced to the idea of limitations was through a TED Talk video by an artist named Phil Hansen. And the name of it is escaping me right now. Oh, it's called Embrace the Shake. And the story is great, and I'm not gonna ruin it for you, except for that conversation from that artist who explained how eliminating all of the options that he could work with, except for the things that he could find to create with, completely exploded his creative self-expression. You know that you get more productive when you come up to right before a deadline. You know that like for many of us, having that deadline explodes our productivity. When we have a creative brief, what we're doing is we're creating the boundaries, the constraints, the limitations for where we're gonna find creative solutions within it. Instead of having to solve all the problems, you only want to solve the relevant problems within your creative brief. You may not think that you use structure and constraints very often and limitation very often in what you do, but it is everywhere in your work. Mark offers how do structures and habits connect for maximum benefit for change. So a habit is something that we do repetitively naturally, such that we don't have to even think about it. A habit is usually engaged by a specific trigger or cue, and then we take an action and we receive a reward. Without the structure of that trigger and cue, and without the structure of knowing here's the trigger, here's the action, and here's the reward, it's very challenging to build new habits. So anytime you can create structure that works for you, that supports you, is gonna support a habit, Mark. So yeah. And just as you hit send, I hit you with forced deadlines. Yeah, so those forced deadlines, the structure of an accountability partner, all of those kinds of things. And even the constraint of saying, you know what? I have all of these different things that I could be talking about in my marketing. I have all these different kinds of services. I have all these different kinds of solutions. If you try to market all of them and talk about all of them and get excited about all of them and make sales in all of them, you're gonna be exhausted and overwhelmed. And guess what? So is your audience. Your audience is going to be hit like a fire hose with all of these different kinds of things. So creating a constraint, creating a structure and a limitation and saying, I'm only gonna focus my messaging on, so like in your case right now, virtual events, virtual event photography and videography. It's a new thing in the event photography industry. You are being a leader and a pioneer in that. You would limit all of your conversations to that new innovation, to how you're being a leader in the transformation of the event industry. That would limit your conversations. You're not gonna like randomly talk about headshots. You wanna really limit through that. Mark says, thank you. My carrot metaphor is the free time and organization of my cloud calendar system. Not sure I get that. But I'm hoping that that is a structure. Oh, so for you, the iCalendar or iCal system. So for Mark, he's created a structure and a system that keeps him organized and focused by using his calendar as an organizational system and using it to structure how he focuses his day. Constraints can be as empowering as just committing to say, I'm gonna constrain my work time to between 7 a.m. and 3 p.m. and I'm not gonna work after 3 p.m. That constrains your focused time, so then you have that deadline, that constraint of I only have from 7 a.m. till 3 p.m. to get this work done, I better really focus. And if you don't do that, sometimes what happens during the day, if you don't have like a specific end time or you haven't constrained the amount of investment you're making in your work that day, you can work until midnight. You could just keep working and then you don't have your lifestyle anymore. So sometimes it's important to look at constraints as a tool to create that separation between here is my business and here is my lifestyle, so that you get an experience of being able to do work you love, to make a living, and to have a life, because that's why we're doing it, right, gang? So if you have been avoiding having any kind of structure in your day, or structure in terms of how you onboard clients, or structure in terms of how you approach specific projects, structure in terms of how you follow up or communicate, all of these structures actually give you more energy and more time and more ability to be creative, to knock their socks off, and to do the work that you love by investing in setting up those constraints, limitations, and structures in advance. So any other questions for my live audience, please go ahead and drop them in the comments. Mark says it's an example of my success in the past. Yes, I want that with my sales, marketing, and social systems. Yes, do work that I love. Yes, I also want to live my life. Absolutely. So thank you for that. And gang, if you're struggling with this, if this is something that you're not really great at, I invite you to join me in my Facebook group. I invite you to go ahead and reach out and book a strategy call with me. Both of those are going to be able to give you access to asking questions about how to create structure, meaningful structure, and how to leverage restraints in your life and your business. So if you have any other questions, drop them in the comments. I always come back and read the threads and engage with you guys. And until next week, at exactly the same time, on exactly the same day, I will be joining you for more conversations about business, marketing, and mindset. I am Aura McKay. I'm the founder of Business of Creativity, and this has been Coaching for Creatives. Thank you so much.